Hey YouTube, what's up? I'm Shakara Danye, and I am here with another message. So, let's get into it. So here it is, August 11th. And I'm just really feeling like, why not me? And this question has been on my mind all day. I journaled about it. And I also been thinking about the movie, The Notebook. And this particular scene is just playing over and over my head. When he said, what is it that you want? Think about it. What is it that you want? And he was talking to his girl, and she couldn't answer. She didn't know what she wanted. She always was trying to factor in everybody else but her. And so he said, what is it that you want? Take everybody else out of the equation. What is it that you want? What's gonna make you happy? And this scene has been in my head. So I know spirit is like, you need to share this. Somebody else is feeling the same way you are. And I'm a little emotional because it's just been a real life up and down roller coaster for some months now. And also, what I've been hearing is I feel like I hit a plateau. You know how they say in a diet and a workout, you start and you're doing good and you start to see results and so you get happy, and then you hit a plateau where it's just like steady. No more changes. You don't lose weight, you don't gain weight. It's just like steady, like, okay, this is just it. So I just really feel like I'm at this point in my journey where, I don't know, I feel like, why not me? In terms of, why can't I have what I want, you know, right now? I feel like Noah in the movie The Notebook. What is it that you want? And I keep asking myself, what is it that you want, girl? You keep on going back and forth. No, I just want to cater to myself. I just need me. I just want me. I'm happy being single. And then I find myself daydreaming about the type of man I want and how I want to be treated in that relationship. And then I'm like, why can't I have that? Why not me? Like, why can't I have a rich man? Like, simple in my head. I'm worth it. I'm enough. And then I'm just like, I hit a plateau. So it's all these things going on in my head. And I really just, I want to flow. I want to just go with the flow. But I feel like it's stagnant. I feel stuck. I feel like none of that of what I want and imagine and wrote in my notebook. Whew. My thoughts have been out of this world. And I'm just like, why can't I have that? I feel like I can't have it. Why not? So, I don't know what's going on with this energy. I don't know what to even do to help it at this point. Like, I'm just here. I'm just experiencing, I guess. So, I'm really just trying to flow. I'm trying to be. I'm trying to just hear, see, and know what it is that I want. What it is that I truly want. And I get to feeling like, I don't know. I don't know what it is that will help me get past this plateau. Like, do I need to journal? I just started a new journal and I'm already, it looked like it's already, I done wrote a lot already. Like, I just started this and I already wrote a lot, I feel like. Like, a lot of the pages are already written in, and I just started this on the 9th, Monday. It's only Wednesday. So, I've been writing a lot. I've been actively trying to change the tide, shift the tide. I've been actively trying to just cleanse my energy. I take intentional showers every day. And just really try to visualize every negative thing washing off of me, because I don't want to be in this negative space. And I'm not going to claim it as negative, but it's just a feeling that I don't want to be in. So I'm trying to move past it, because in this journey, you will find that things trigger you, things happen so that you can feel them, not suppress them, not brush them under the rug, but feel them and get through them. So this is what I'm trying to do. So I write it down, I get them off of my mind, the daydreams, the wants, the needs, and everything in between. And I still just sit here on this here stool and I just be like, spirit, what's going on? Ancestors, what's going on? God, universe, somebody, like, am I being heard? Am I not? What's going on? I feel that stagnant, that stuck, that just you know. So, I just came on here to really just try to shed some light on each thing that I spoke about. The what is it that you really want? That scene sticks out to me because we are always trying to see what it is that other people want besides ourselves first. Like, what's so wrong with putting yourself first? Like, you are important too. Like, yes, you want everybody else around you that you love to be happy too, but you are worth being happy as well. And in that scene, she was really like, man, I could see it in her face. Like, I know I want you, Noah. I want to be with you. But I have already moved on. And I have a fiance that is wanting to marry me. We are planning a wedding at this moment. And by the way, I love that movie. So it's just like, that scene just spirit really wanted me to focus on it. And she was just like, well, he's gonna be hurt, you're gonna be hurt, whoever else. And he didn't care about that. He said, what do you want, woman? What do you want? Doesn't matter what anybody else is wanting. What I want, what he want, what your mom want, it doesn't matter. What do you want? And she still couldn't answer in that moment. She has to drive away and read a letter from him. And then she could decide. So sometimes you just have to go through these moments of, I don't know what I want. But once I do something else or move past this, then maybe I will figure it out, you know. So then you get to journaling and just write down your real and raw feelings, get through it, and then maybe on the other side of that, you'll know what it is that you want. So I tried to do that today. And Why Not Me was the title of it. Like, why not me be spoiled? That's what I want. I want to be spoiled because I haven't ever had that. I'm always independent, self-sufficient. That's how I was raised. So it's just naturally in me. I don't know how to ask for help or to have my hand out. I get it on my own, or I just do what I gotta do or whatever. But now I'm in a space of, why can't I have someone that wants to come in and cater to me and spoil me and want me to just relax and he have it all under control? Why not me? Why not me be rich and wealthy for real, you know? So these are my thoughts as I'm journaling. And then I'm like, ugh, Shakara, you need to make up your mind. Because one day you're saying, no, I just want to focus on myself, I'm okay being single. And then the next day you like, ooh, that'd be nice if husband would do that. Ma'am, you're confusing. What is it that you want? You want a husband or you don't? You want to be single or you don't? You tired of being single or you okay with it? Like, you gotta decide. Can't be up on the fence about that, because how do you expect to get what you want when you are confusing your damn self, you know? So I really had to sit and ponder with this on why I feel like, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's okay to really just want to cater to yourself and be content being single. Being content is great because you're flowing, you just letting things happen how they happen, and you not trying to change the outcome. Because I got that bad. Like, I be trying to control because I'm used to being self-sufficient. Like, what I can control over here in my world, that makes me at peace. And so I be having to let go of that control. And so I was just like, okay, What is it that makes me say I'm comfortable with being by myself? A defense mechanism. Because I feel like all these years of dealing with someone else, it's just like I put myself on the back burner. And then when it was time for them to be there for me, they wasn't ever there. So it was just like, oh, wow, okay. So I should have just chose myself all along. Like, why not me? Choose myself, love myself, do for myself like I've been doing. So why not? But that's not going to get me as exactly what it is that I really want. I really want love. I really want the love that I envision for myself. I really want to share my life with someone without the pain, without the hardship of unnecessary things that may happen inside a relationship that I was used to in the past. So I really seen that, okay, I'm just referring back to my past instead of creating something new, that it doesn't have to be. It won't be the same. God already told me that. It's not going to be the same with you. It's not going to be like it was in the past. It's not going to be like that. But I'm having a hard time with that because it's like, why can't I have it the way I want it, you know? Why can't I just have a husband and we travel and we be rich and we just live this life and we be good, content, everything? I really don't want kids. I really don't want that for myself. Now, that's something that it was like, I really had to think about. And that's very true. I really don't want kids. And the fact that I don't want kids makes me think like, okay, mate, well, maybe I'm just not cut out for a relationship then. Because a man is eventually gonna want kids, right? Unless he say the same thing. Like, can I have that? Can I have a man that don't want no kids either? Don't have no kids? And then we move like that, you know? But I see all sides to everything sometimes. And that is like a blessing and a curse. Because I just understand, over-understand, understand, all of that. All the time. So I look at it at different perspectives. Like, okay, could I change my mind on this? Could I want a kid? No, I really don't want a kid. So that's like another reason why I'm just like, okay, well, I'm cool with just being single. Because I'm standing firm on that. Like, I'll stand firm on that. If I gotta be single for the rest of my life because I don't want no kids, then so be it. I'm happy with that. But then I'm like, will I not get anything else that I manifest and want because I don't want no kids? It's just be a lot. And I'm just having a moment where I'm just like, what is life? I'm tired of thinking. I'm tired of thinking about this. And it's simple. You know, you could just be like, whatever flows to you, flows to you. You know, you don't have any control over that sometimes. You really were born with a plan already. It's already written in the stars. And so You're stressing yourself out, saying what you don't want, what you want out of this. You don't even remember what you signed up for. So then I had a moment where I'm just like, who the fuck would sign up for this life? Like, why wouldn't I sign up to just automatically be rich? Like, these are the thoughts that go in my mind. And I'm just like, who would choose this? Like, I'm not saying I got a bad life. Like, I'm very appreciative and grateful for everything. I got my own place, I got my own car. I'm good. But it's just the simple things that just make you want to just be like, it was simple to just sign a contract of a rich already. Like, I gotta go through other people to get rich. I don't like that. I don't like it at all. I just wanna be rich. Like, how can I get rich? I don't know how to get rich either. So then my mind goes off into a tangent again and be like, well, it's you. You the star. You the seed. It's you that's gonna make yourself rich. Cause you already wealthy. You already rich. You already that. Okay? So you don't gotta do too much. And when you realize that, then maybe it'll, just flood on in. And so I really be having these moments with myself, like, let me not think so hard. And I just be like, why? Why am I made like this? Why do I have to think about everything? Why can't I just live and be free? To just go do some things that I haven't done before and not give a fuck. But no, I'm responsible. I think about everything 2 times, 3 times, 4 times if it's real risky. And then I may act on it. Or I might just write it down and get it out my head and off my heart and not do nothing of what I thought about. So I just came on here to just get this off my chest, I guess. To let you know that even if you're at a plateau in your journey, in your life right now, it's okay. You are exactly where you need to be. You're not late. You're not stagnant. You're not slowing down the course. Excuse me. You are exactly where you need to be because God is still using you. Just like I got up here on this camera saying what my issues are. Somebody out there is dealing with the same thing. They don't know what to do right now. They don't know how to feel. They don't know what they should be doing. So then, in those moments when they're trying to figure it out, trying to feel like they help in spirit, doing something to help, they tap into their talent or their power or whatever it is that they may do. And guess what? That's gonna help somebody else too. So if this video helps just one person that see it and listen to it, that's well within my soul. And you're gonna make it. You're gonna get through, and you're going to look back and be like, man, at that point in my life, I didn't know which way I was going. I didn't know what it was that was for me, that wasn't for me, what I was supposed to be doing, not doing, feeling, not feeling. In those moments, God is using you the most. When you feel like you can't even hear what it is that spirit is telling you, trying to tell you, signs, symbols, everything could be in your face and you still be like, can you please make it clear? And they probably just like, ciao. Just calm down. Be cool. We got you. We got you. Trust us, okay? Just trust us. We gonna get you through this. We've been getting you through it. It's not the first time that you felt like this. It's not the first time that you felt like nothing was going in your favor. But you got through those moments to a better situation. And now you back in a moment of feeling like that. So guess what's going to happen once you get through this feeling of you don't know, something's better is behind that. You know, a door is going to be open. Something is going to happen to catapult you into the next season of flow, of abundance, of prosperity, of success, of answered prayers, of whatever it is that you may need. So be encouraged to keep going, even when you don't know, even when you feel like it's the plateau, even when you cannot answer the question of what do you want, even when you just have all these things, questions of why not me, and you still just can't find the answer. Keep going, keep pushing, keep doing what's going to help you get out of this season of being still. Keep going, because on the other side is your overflow. It's waiting for you. You just gotta decide what it is that's gonna get you there. So don't give up. Keep going. So that's all I got for you today. I hope this helps you. It helped me to get it off my chest. So thank you for joining. If you haven't already, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, and there will be more messages of encouragement, of readings, of whatever it is that spirit lays on my heart. It'll be on this channel. So thank you again, and I will see y'all later. Peace.